Hi guys, I am back again with another tutorial. This one's a bit different. This one's going to be makeup related. I do apologise for the state of my hair, but if you've seen my last video, you do know it is quite badly damaged from bleaching, but it's getting there. Anyway, today's tutorial is going to be a Katy Perry look, and I've been wanting to do this for a while, but I don't know why I haven't done it. I just haven't got around to it. And basically, I went to see her in May on her Prismatic World Tour, and it was amazing. I've said before how much I love Katy Perry, and she's just my favourite person. And I am obsessed with the makeup that she wears on stage on her tour. It's quite basic, but it's got a little bit of like pizzazz to it because it's got glitter under the eyes. So this would be pretty affordable as well, and I'm going to do my best to try and recreate it. I was inspired by a certain picture that I saw on Tumblr, which I will link below, but I'm obsessed with it. I copied it when I went to see her as well, so this is kind of like a recreation of that look. I'm wearing my Prism shirt today, or one of them. But I bought when I went to see her. If you went to see her, also let me know. Or if you're going to see her, you're going to have the best time. Just come like fangirl with me. Come fangirl with me on Tumblr, do it on Twitter, I'll link everything down below in the comments. Just, I need more Katy Cat friends because I haven't got any. I haven't got enough. I'll list everything in the description box, just in case I forget something. But I'm going to start off with foundation. Now, Katy uses the CoverGirl foundation, obviously because she is a CoverGirl, but we don't get CoverGirl over here. So I'm going to use the Bourjois Healthy Mix Serum in 51 Vanilla Clay, which is obviously a lot lighter than she is, but I am pale as ever. So I'm just going to apply that using a Real Techniques buffing brush. I'm running out of this foundation, so I'm just going to use this stick to apply it in some lines where I removed it. I've already got mascara on, but that's because I wasn't actually going to film this today, because I set everything up, and then my mother came home, and I don't like filming when there's like people around, because they think I'm weird enough as it is. Her face is quite flawless. Obviously she gets blemishes like the rest of us. I'm breaking out pretty badly right now because of stress. You just want to cover them up because she's got quite a flawless face. And I was just reading an interview with her makeup artist, and he said the way he gets it to stay when she's on stage dancing, all that, he does like a light layer of foundation, then powders over it, then does another one. So it's kind of all about building it up. I'm just using extra foundation to cover up any spots that I have. I'm just going to put a little bit extra under my eyes. I'm not a makeup artist, by the way, so if you do things differently to me, that is cool. You do you, I'll do me, in the words of Tiger Oakley. Okay, that's done. Next, I'm going to powder because it is quite a matte look, so I'm just using the Constance Carroll Silk Finishing Powder. So I'm just gonna, I'm using, this brush is hella old, but it's from Sephora. There's a foundation on one and a powder on the other end, and I'm just gonna push it in instead of brushing it on, because that will wipe off all the makeup I've just put on. And I'm just gonna put it in areas where I'd sweat the most. Above the lips, T-zone, chin, and then down onto the neck. Next, onto the cheeks. She's not got blush on, she's kind of got a bronzer on. This used to be Jelly Pong Pong, it's called Sor Susan now. And it's the Brazilian Sun like bronzer. And it comes in a box like this. Excuse me, this is face paint I've been practicing for Halloween. And it comes in a little powder puff like this, and it looks like this. And then I'm going to take a standard blush brush, this one's from Topshop, contour, and I'm just going to take a little bit and run this underneath my cheekbones just like on the cheeks, because she doesn't really have it on the face. She just kind of has it on the edges. A little bit of the temples, jawline, down my nose. Okay, next on to the eyes. The eyeshadow itself is quite basic. Lots of liner, false eyelashes, and glitter eyeliner underneath, so that's what we're going to do. I'm using a eyeshadow primer. This is the Avon one, and it's in light beige. This looks like this, the label's come off. And I'm going to use my finger to apply that, ring finger, because it's the most gentle one and your eyes are very sensitive. So we just put all over the lid and up to the brow bone, and one more silver left underneath. In case you were wondering, my nail polish is Rose Hip Bavarian. It's a very nice colour. Right, if you've got the Urban Decay Naked Palette, this would be a good one for it, but I don't. So I'm using the Avon 8-in-1 Eye Palette in neutral tones, and I'm just going to use this colour, which is the lightest. It's a just a regular eyeshadow brush. This is the base shadow brush from Real Techniques. And then just pat that on the top. Use any nude shade, any skin, like whatever matches your skin colour. Use that. Gonna put a little bit of that on the inner corners as well, just to brighten them up. And next, I'm going to take the accent brush. You can use any brush, you don't have to do this left if you don't want to, but the crease is quite, in the picture I've got, the crease is quite like noticeable, so that's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to use matte brown for that. So I've got this, which is really, really old. It's from eBay. It's a similar, it's similar to the BH Cosmetics 120 palette, but I'm guessing not as good. So you just want a matte brown. I'm using right here. And you just want to put that in your crease. It doesn't matter if it's messy, because we're going to blend it out anyway. Just, if you don't want it to be this obvious, you can just go in with a blending brush and, you know, blend it out. But, and then I'm using the Deluxe Crease Brush from Real Techniques. Why do I keep saying Techniques? Techniques. And I'm just wind wiper motions, same on this eye. So that is the eyeshadow done. Next on to the liner. This is quite a big bit of it, quite a big wing going on. So you can either use liquid liner or gel eyeliner, it's totally up to you. I am going to use gel eyeliner and an angled brush. This one is from Topshop. I'm using the Collection gel eyeliner. Mine's a bit, definitely a bit used. So I'm just going to take an eyeliner, an angled brush, and load it up. And it's quite a big wing, so however you do your wings, you do it that way. But I start on the edge, quite thin, and then go out. And you want it to be quite, not an extreme wing, but quite a big wing. You start here, and go across. Your whole eye first, and then work on the wing. It looks about right. You want it to be quite sharp on the end, so try and get that, find it so it just looks like that. It's up to you, it's totally preference if you want to go up, down, straight across, whatever, but this is kind of what it looks like in the picture, so. I'm just gonna thicken them up, tidy them up. I'm just gonna also take a little bit of foundation and any brush really, and just like clean up. Just so they're very sharp. Put on to the key bit of the look, which is the glitter liner underneath the eyes. I'm going to show you two ways to do this. One if you have glitter liner, one if you don't. Or if you wanted to be a bit more kind of like daytime friendly. If you wanted to be a bit more daytime friendly, just do this and then the lip and you're good to go. I know underneath her eyes she's got MAC Reflex and I think it's Pearl. So if you've got that, great, use it. I don't, so I'm going to be using a glitter liner and mine's a lot more blue than hers was. But you want it to have that prismatic feel, so you want a lot of colours. You don't just want one silver like line. But this is the best I could find and this is the Collection Glam Crystals Dazzling Gel Eyeliner in Hustle. Looks like this. It's a lot more blue. I'm going to show you another way to do it. So I'm going to take an angled brush and this is the brow brush from the Real Techniques. Okay. I'm going to first wet it, or if you've got mixing medium you can use that or you can use water. It's totally up to you, but you want it to be wet so that the eyeshadow goes on and looks a lot better. And I'm going to take a silver eyeshadow. This is like from Boots, I had it ages ago, but any silver eyeshadow will do. I'm going to use this one. Something from Urban Decay would be good, no doubt, because they're always good with any pigmented eyeshadows. And then I'm just going to put this underneath my eye and the lower lash line. It's quite thick because it's quite noticeable. She hasn't really got anything in the waterline, so if you want you can use a nude eyeliner or a white one. And then lashes, lip, good to go. I've got my glitter eyeliner and I'm basically just going to do exactly the same and put it underneath. Make sure you get loads of glitter. So she's got quite a lot, so when she's on stage and the light catches it, you can see it. If you don't want that much, don't put that much. If you just want a little bit, put a little bit. But you have no idea the struggles I went to try and find a glitter eyeliner that I deemed good enough or close enough to hers for when I went to see her. It took me a good like 3 or 4 shops before I went back to the first shop and then got this one. So that is the glitter liner done. It looks a bit much, but you know KP, she loves a bit of makeup. Next, I'm going to do the eyebrows, actually. I do my eyebrows a bit weirdly because, as you can see, they're pretty thick anyway and I just like a little bit of like definition to them. So what I do is I use a brow brush, or whatever you call it. This one's from H&M and it's double-ended eyelash eyebrows. This is the Real Techniques one and I'm using, this is from Primark, but use your brow colour, it's totally up to you. I'm just going to take the light brown and what I do is I do this. I know this probably isn't the right way to do it, but this is the way I do it because then I only get that little bit of definition I want. And I just start at the beginning of my eyebrow and just brush it through. So just for a little bit of definition on the brows. See the difference? And I'm going to do the same on the other side. You do your brows however you do your brows, but hers aren't crazy defined. They look very natural and just like very tidy. And I'm going to curl my eyelashes, but only a little bit, in the model's own eyelash curler in case anybody was wondering. Oops. Next up is lashes. Now I'm not 100% sure what lashes Katie is wearing because I couldn't find it, but they look a lot like her Oh My Lashes from her Eyelow range, which I had but I've lost. But they are really really thick and really really nice. I'm kind of gutted I've lost them. For this look I'm going to use her rebrand ones, her new ones, are in Banging Beauty. I picked up House of Eyelashes from Pixie Woo. If you don't know who they are Sam and Nick, and they are makeup artists / gurus here on YouTube. I will link them below. So I'm just going to take a little bit of eyelash glue. This is just the one that came with the packet. I'm just going to run it and a bit of it along. Seems it's been like putting a little bit extra on the corners because that's where it lifts up the most. They do recommend you cut them in half so that your eyelashes don't bend at the corners and like come up. Just wait till they're tacky. And you can use tweezers if you want to, but I feel a bit more confident when I use my fingers. And just look down and place them in the middle. Tuck in the corners. If you're going to make any adjustments, do it before they dry. I will link Sam and Nick's video because it's much better than mine is, but whenever the lashes aren't, I'm going to do the other ones and then be right back. That's the eyes done. I'm going to wait for the eyelashes to dry and then go back over a little bit of mascara just to dry my own eyelashes. But we will move on to the lips. On her lips, she's got quite a muted pink colour. It's the one she wears quite often because I know she does her own lips. I will try and find out which one she wears and I'll link it in the bottom. I know it's MAC, but I'm not sure which MAC. I have got here NYX Black Label lipstick in Hot Tamale, which is quite a similar pink, if you can see from the bottom. First things first, you want to line your lips. So I've got this clear one from Avon, which is a new lip filling lip liner, and it's clear, so it's good for like anything. And you just want to line your lips so this will stay on. So I'm just gonna, oh, lovely bit of eyeshadow on my lips there. Outline and fill in. If you want to, and you have a coloured lip liner, you can overdraw yours. Okay, so I'm just going to use a lip brush and then get the lipstick. I think she's just filling her lips with the lip liner and then gone. But I haven't got that lip liner, so I'm just using the Hot Tamale and I'm just going to use a little bit of mascara to join my lashes to the false ones, and I'm going to use the new Barry M one, which is Showgirl, and I'm using the lengthening one. Katie uses the CoverGirl Lash Blast, I do believe it's called. We don't get CoverGirl in the UK, which sucks. So I'm using it. Does anybody else get that thing where they do one eye really good, your eyelashes look amazing, and the eyelashes on your other eye are like rubbish and don't do nothing? Because that is this is what's happening right now. I'm gonna put a tiny little bit of mascara on my bottom lashes just for some definition. Then you can do your hair like Katie, don your wig, whatever. If you just wanna, you know, stroll around the neighborhood like this, then it is done. So this is the finished look. I do hope you enjoyed this video. I might do a Halloween one because I've got quite a few face charts lying around. You probably can't see them because they have folded over on themselves, but I've got quite a few, so I might do a get ready with me Halloween video. Let me know your favourite Katy Perry song down in the comments. Mine has got to be Legendary Lovers. Oh, I can't believe she hasn't released it as a single yet. It's amazing. It's my ringtone. I went mental when I saw her. Let me know if you're going to see her on the Prismatic World Tour. Give this video a thumbs up if you liked it, and don't forget to subscribe, and I will see you next time. Bye!